Russia will need to react to the expansion of a U.S. anti-missile defense system in South Korea, its deputy foreign minister has said. It inevitably will raise the question about our reaction, about our military balances, Sergei Ryabkov told reporters at a summit in China. His comments followed Seoul's announcement that it was strengthening its AAAD Terminal High Altitude Area Defense System THAAD, after North Korea tested a hydrogen bomb over the weekend. South Korea simulates attack on North Korea's nuclear sites. The anti-missile system has already created diplomatic tensions between South Korea and China, as Beijing believes its radar could be used to monitor its activities. Russia and China, old rivals who appear to have found common ground on the North Korean issue, have criticized America's militarization of the Korean Peninsula. Relations between Moscow and Washington broke down further last week when Donald Trump's administration forced Russia to close its consulate in San Francisco and scale back its diplomatic presence in Washington and New York. In response to the nuclear test, South Korea also completed live-fire drills off its eastern coast, simulating an attack on the North's main nuclear test site. North Korea has repeatedly defied United Nations UN sanctions by developing nuclear weapons and testing missile systems. In August, the isolated communist state sent an intercontinental missile over mainland Japan that landed in the Pacific Ocean. It also threatened to attack the U.S. territory of Guam, a small Pacific island used as an American military base. The U.S. has warned that any threats to itself, its territories, or its allies will be met with a massive military response. U.S. North Korea could be met with massive military response. North Korea has been under UN sanctions since 2006 for its nuclear and ballistic missiles programs. The UN Security Council last month unanimously imposed new sanctions on the North over two of its long-range missile launchers in July. The sanctions focused on North Korean exports of coal, iron, lead, and seafood. Officials have said the UN could next consider banning textile exports from the North and stop supplying oil to the government and military. North Koreans could also be prevented from working abroad and senior officials could be banned from traveling. U.S. President Donald Trump has threatened to stop all trade with countries doing business with the North, a veiled warning to China. But Geng Shuang, a Chinese foreign ministry spokesman, told reporters at a briefing in Beijing this week that such measures would be neither objective nor fair. More about Russia, North Korea, South Korea, China reuse content.